Hi children, how are you all? I'm Mrs. Celestina, going to take you the first prose lesson is First Flight. Before that, we are going to sing a song. Due to this COVID-19, we know that we are in trouble, but still we have to overcome from that. Shall we sing the song together? We shall overcome, we shall overcome, we shall overcome someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. Yes, children, we should know that we are capable, we are strong, we are enough to fight the COVID-19. We can overcome from this crisis. Shall we go to the lesson right now? Okay, fine. Before that, the first step in our life after the childhood to come over to that 9th standard or 10th standard level, we should take a first step in life. So we need the courage to take the first step. We should not get afraid of ourselves. This is a story behind this. It's First Flight. In the prose lesson teaches us that we should able to be brave enough to take the first step. Then only we can achieve our goal. Fine. Shall we go to the new words? Glossary. See, in this topic, we see that word ledge. Pronounce it ledge. That means the narrow shelf. That means ledge means a narrow shelf. The second word, shilly. The bird, small bird, baby bird, started to cry because could not able to fly. He needs the help from his mother, started crying, begging to his mother. So the bird started crying, producing a high pitched sound. In a shrill voice, the bird cries. The third word, herring. The word herring, that means a long silver fish. A long silver fish. Next one, fourth one, diver. That means the brother bird of this small seagull bird just caught the fish and started devouring it, gulping it, swallowing it, okay? To eat eagerly in large quantity or amount, in the full mouthful. Next one is cackle. Cackle, a sharp broken noise. A sharp broken noise. Next word is mackerel. The word mackerel is a sea fish which is found in a large amount where the birds can catch easily and eat. Okay, fine. These are the few words. Then nodded means worried. Means worried. Nodded. Tottered means ran at short step. That means it's not coming very fast, it's not coming very slow, moving front and back. In the cliff itself, the bird trying to fly. That's what is tottered. Precipice. It's not pice, P-I-C, not pice. Precipice. P-I-S in the phonetic sound. P-I-S. Precipice. A very steep rock face. This is a steep rock face. It's very steep, sharp edges. Peak in that. Whip. Sharpens. When the bird, after eating the fish, the birds used to sharp their teeth, isn't it? That is whip. Sharpen. Plaintively. pitiful little voice, plaintively. Swooped is flying downwards through the air. From here, the bird started flying downward to the air. It's called swoop. So these are the new words in our prose lesson today. Right. Shall we go to the lesson now? Okay, children. See, the story begins like this. Mother bird, seagull, father seagull, brother seagull, younger sister seagull, and the elder brother seagull. This, all the five of them were staying in the ledge of the peak. These little ones flapped their feathers, started flying in the air, started leading their life. But this little one, seagull, you know what is seagull? They say it in kadal kagam. Seagull means kadal kagam. Okay, fine. The seagull, which was afraid to fly, was never tried to take a forward step, never flatten his feathers. His mother called him, screamed at him, scolded at him, but there were no steps taken by the small seagull. What the other birds started flying, this brother got the first catch, herring, the long silver fish, and gulped it in one mouth. They were enjoying the nature, flying here and there, catching fish and eating. This poor little one did not try himself to fly off. What his mother did, she tried in all the means. She came around him, circled him, screamed that take a first step and start fly, take move forward. She just came near the edge and started asking him, just take a step, take a step, take a step. But the bird tortured himself, cried himself, pretended himself, but never started fluttering his feathers. Finally, what the mother asked, if you are not ready to fly, you are not going to get any food. You have to stop at your place. So they were enjoying the food and flying. The bird cried over, starved. Finally, he found some of the pieces of dry piece of mackerel's tail of the mackerel fish. Mackerel fish means, in Tamil they say ailamin. Okay, that mackerel fish dried tail was there in their nest. Finally, he could take the food of the dry mackerel's tail as its food. Moreover, this little bird started eating the eggshells of their own, which they were hatched from it. And that nest was dirty enough with the stars and their waste, but still no other go, because this little bird did not try at all to fly. The 24 hours had gone. The new dawn has come next day. What do you mean dawn? Sir, sun rising in the morning. What is the opposite of dawn? Dusk. D-U-S-K. Dusk. That means sun descending. So the sun started ascending on the sky. It's a blazing. What does it mean blazing? Yes, this is the situation. We are getting the blazing sun. It's very hot. There, the sun was blazing. Top, the birds were flying, enjoying the nature, catching the food and eating again. What the mother tried a trick. She said to him, okay, she caught a fish, tagged it, took a piece of it in her beak, came near to the little bird. She said, come, catch it, catch it, catch it, your food for you. The bird came near to this And the little bird came near to the ledge to catch the food from his mother's beak. But the mother bird flew away. The little bird dived down the air and swooped, started stretching his feathers and to fly in the sky. The little bird learned the art of flying. So here the author wished to say us, even though we have multiple talents, we have got not a single talent, we have got multiple talents within us. The author trying to say that we should able to use them at the right time. So God's gift for us, the talents are like gold coins. If we are not able to use that in the particular right time, we miss the gold. The same way, finally the bird, little bird seagull, tried and started flying in the sky. So, when they started flying in the sky, this all the mother, father bird and the brother and sister birds, they were applauded at him, screamed and encouraged the little bird. Very good, well done, you have done at least in the last moment. Come on, you can stretch your feathers, flap it nicely. This is the way we should fly. They taught him, they guided him, they encouraged him to fly. The little seagull started flying in the sky with a great joyful manner. The bird was very happy, started catching little fish, started eating his food in a regular manner. This is the way the mother bird taught the bird to overcome its fear. At home, even our parents teach us how to behave, how to remodel ourselves according to the nature, the surrounding, in the circumstances among us, in between our younger ones at home, elderly people, to the parents, to the teachers at school, to the society, nearby our neighbors. We should be polite enough to reach out to them. We should be soft enough, calm enough to be nice with our younger ones. To the elders, we should listen. We should obey what parents says. Here, the mother bird going on teaching to him to take a step. The same way, even our parents, they guide us to take a new step in our life, to come over, to achieve our goal, to do our work, to do our daily work in this manner to reach out our goal. The next thing, when we behave with the surrounding, to the nature, we should be surprised, enjoyed, and to take over all the riches, resources in the nature, which God has blessed us with the resources. We should know how to enjoy it in a right manner. We should not exploit it. We should not exploit it. We should enjoy the resources which God has given us. And moreover, here in the sea, there are plentiful fishes of it. Some are eatable, some are not. So we should know what to take, what not to take in our life too. These birds, they catch only some type of fish to eat. The same manner, we also should know what to consume, what not to consume. We should not take anything and everything or at a time together, whatever it is. There's a control between our balanced diet, right? This also one of the teaching the mother bird shows to them. Next thing, when you scoop down to the earth, That means you are not going down. You should learn. That means even though when we take our steps, when we take attempt, some attempt may fail. All the thing will not go in a smoother manner. But we should not frighten. We should not frighten at all. We should able to encourage ourselves, pick up and move again, start again, take a next attempt, get through it, go through it, get until unless you achieve the goal, you should not leave it. Right? This another teaching of this rose lesson for us, when we take an attempt, even though we may fail in that, don't stop with that attempt alone. We have to go further and further, try again, try again, try again. You will achieve the goal. You can get through that attempt. That is the lesson two. Next one, when we come out of our surrounding, the world is not a little one. It's a wider path. So far, we are all children. Right now, in 10th standard, after 10th, we are going to see the world in a wider manner. For that manner, you should prepare yourself. You should get ready yourself to learn more, to behave in a proper manner, to feel your responsibilities, especially in your studies, in your behavior, in your discipline, etc. So the same manner, this little bird did not try at all in the beginning, giving so many excuses. It felt the feather were not able to help him to fly. All this malpractice and mal excuses, the simple laziness, all this idiotism. But we, the student of 10th standard, should able to feel the responsibilities which are given to us. For in this year, especially in this lockdown period, we should not take it easy. Take your responsibilities in your hand. Try your level best to follow your studies through the online teaching. Take the lessons together. Learn it properly. Do your homework regularly. Learn it nicely. Get ready. Prepare yourself for this academic year. This also is the first step. This little bird teaching us how to come out of ourselves to learn the responsibilities. Okay, then the bird, the mother bird, responsibility is, though this little one has started flying, she did not leave this little bird alone. She took the responsibility all to rear all these three children. Even our parents too, they take the responsibility, even though they eat or not, they sleep or not, they drink or not, they take care of us. They love us. They are always at the back of us. For what purpose? My children are very precious for me. They are gift of God for me, for us as a parents. So they love us in such extent. They show the love, all everything put together to rear us in a better manner, to be a better human in this life and to the society. So they work very hard for us children. You should give respect to your parents, listen to them, obey them, as this mother bird trained the little one. Fine? Okay. What does the brother and sister were doing to this little one? They were shouting, scolding him even. They were training him. At home also, even our elder sister or brother, they may train us not to do this, not to do that. You sit and learn, or you learn it properly. Don't play outside. Wear mask. All these rules are given for us. For what sake? For our betterment. For betterment sake, to be safe at home, to stay at home, to safeguard ourselves from the danger from outside. So we should able to listen to the elders. That is the more moral these little birds are teaching to the this young seagull. Okay, children, so far we have learned this prose lessons topic of this as fast flies regarding the small seagull's first flight. Okay, now we go for the recap. The small bird which was sitting on the ledge, and the characters of this topic is fast flight, Limbo, Happy, the author of the topic. How many characters are there? 6. The young seagull, his 2 brothers, his little sister, and his father and mother. Then the story of the topic. The young seagull was not ready to fly because afraid of flying. His brothers and sister already flown. His father and mother came around calling him to fly. He was threatened by his parents to starve. There's no one, these birds, no one came near to this seagull. So the seagull was alone, feeling hungry. His younger brother's first catch was a herring. What I told you, what is the meaning of herring? It's a long silver fish. The first catch of the brother, one of his younger brothers, was herring. His family circled around him and cackled when shouted. This seagull's family started surrounding him, started shouting at him, cackling at him to fly off from his birthplace. He ran front and back due to hunger. This little one could not get any food, so started running front and back due to hunger. He ate the dried mackerel's tail. Mackerel means one type of fish, like Tamil they say, Aila mean. Mackerel say dried piece, already eaten off. Only the bone with the tail was left over. That dried leftover tail was its food because this bird was not ready to fly. It was starving. Say the bird could find only the dried mackerel's tail as its food. No food was found except he even gnawed at the dried pieces of eggshells. As I told before, even the eggshells which was given birth to this from the eggshells, no, that dried eggshells were left over there in the nest. That was his food. That young bird felt as if it was eating its own flesh. Okay, then they trotted back and forth to reach his parents. This bird trying to reach his parents, so it was moving front and back, moving front and back to reach his parents, but should not, he did not flap his feathers to try to fly. He never ready to move, to fly off. But there was a deep wide crack between the sea. His mother caught a fish and brought it closer to the bird, seagull, to him, to show him, to get him mad. With a great hunger, he moved forward and came off from the ledge. Because the little bird was very hungry, seeing the fish from his mother's beak, he moved forward and came off from the ledge. He started to flap his feathers and dive. When he came out of the ledge, started flapping his feathers and dive into the air. So this was the topic today that we have learned in this poetry prose session, The Hare's First Flight. Okay, shall we go through the glossary again? As I told you before, ledge means a narrow shelf. Schley, producing a high pitched sound. Herring, a long silver sea fish. Deaver, to eat eagerly in large. Cackle, a sharp broken noise. Mackerel, a sea fish. Not means worried. Tottered, ran at short steps. Precipice, a very steep rock face, that means cliff. Preening, cleaning its feathers with its beak. With, sharpen. Plaintively, pitiful little voice. Swooped, flying downwards through the air. Fine. Here we have got some antonyms in our lesson. Young, opposite of young, antonym, old. Before, after. Certain, uncertain. Appear, disappear. Ascending, descending. Wide, narrow. Deep, shallow. The sea is deep. The shore is shallow. The sea is wide. The river is narrow. The sun is ascending. Evening, the sun is descending. Morning, the sun appears. Evening, the sun disappears. We are certain enough to say something. Some things we cannot say. That means uncertain, not sure. Before means previous. After means next, what is going to make. Young and old, you know it. So, today's work, I'm going to give you some of the synonyms here as your homework. You are going to write it, find out the words and write it as your homework. Just copy it down, certain, you should find out the meaning. Desperate, perfecting, here the word with present participle, perfect ing, ing. That means training. The mother parents were perfecting the little bird to train. That is the word perfecting. Okay. Then cowardice means one who is not to act bravely. They say cowardice. Blazing. Maddened. Due to the hunger, the little bird was maddened himself. So please find out the synonyms of these words. Some of the antonyms are near. What is the opposite of it? Find out and write. Slowly, back, end, forward, high. These are the few words for your homework to write there. So far we have seen the synonyms and antonyms as your homework. Now I am going to ask some oral questions to you. Fine? Okay. The first one, why did the seagull fail to fly? Why did the seagull failed to fly. Why? Because the answer should begin with because the young seagull was afraid of flying. We should write the answer when the question comes with why. We should answer because the young seagull was afraid of flying. Fine. Did you understand that answer? Okay. Now, again I repeat the question. Why did the seagull fail to fly? What you are going to answer? The young seagull was afraid of flying because it was not ready to fly. That was the reason. Next question. What was the first catch of the young seagull's older brother? Here, older brother is here. Third one. What was the first catch? I have given you the answer here itself on the blackboard. Herring. What is the meaning of herring? A long, thin, silver fish. We say it in Tamil, valamin. Okay, the shiny one. Long, silver fish in the seaside. Okay. So again, I repeat the question. What was the first catch of the young seagull's older brother? The first catch of the young seagull's older brother was. Everything is in the question. Just check it out. Find it over. The first catch of the young seagull's older brother. Then use the word was. You should write only this one word. Herring. That means a long silver fish. Fine. Did you understand it? Okay. Shall we go once more? What was the first catch of the young seagull's older brother? The young seagull's older brother's first catch was herring. Fine. Okay. The third one. What made the young seagull got mad? What made it? Hunger. Very good. The young seagulls got mad because due to the hunger. Because the bird was very hungry. That's why the young seagull got mad. Next one. Did the mother bird offer any food to the younger seagull? Just go through the question again. Did the mother bird offer any food to the young seagull? Did she offer any food? No. That was the single word answer. No. No, the mother bird did not offer any food to the young seagull. Come on, repeat again. No, the mother bird did not, we should add the word, did not offer any food to the young seagull. That was the answer. So will you please write the questions here from this? Write it down. Write the answers. Write the answers. Write at least thrice. That means three times. And learn it. Shall I repeat the answer once again? One by one? Okay. Listen. Why did the seagull fail to fly? Because the seagull was afraid of flying. That was the first answer. Second one. What was the first catch of the young seagull's older brother? The first catch of the young seagull's old brother was herring, a long silver fish. Next one, what made the young seagull got mad? Hunger made him that to get mad. That means the young seagull got mad because of hunger. Why did the mother bird offer any food to the young seagull? Did the mother bird offer any food to the young seagull? What is the answer? Single word answer. No, the mother bird did not, you should word, use the word, did not offer any food to the young seagull. Okay, fine children. Now, I know that some of you cannot able to go through the single language pattern. I am going to say the story in a nutshell in a second language, Tamil. Shall we? Okay. Kadal kaham, that is called seagull. Appa amma oda in the baby kadal kaga enna seiranga family a inge irukanga mottham 6 per father mother elder brother younger sister another elder brother this one was the fifth bird fifth born okay in the seagull vande anjaadu perandavanga ivunga ella chinna kulandhengalukku amma salli kudutha mari rakka virisi paraka aarambichitaanga paraka aarambichi enna senjanga kadal la meen pidichi avungale saapra alavukku தெளிவாயிட்டாங்க இந்த ஹெரிங் வந்து இவங்க அண்ணன் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பிடிச்ச ஒரு மீன் பேர் ஹெரிங் மீன்ஸ் வாள மீன் தமிழ்ல சொல்வோம் இல்லையா அது இங்கிலீஷ்ல ஹெரிங் சொல்வாங்க லாங் சில்வர் ஃபிஷ் ஓகே இவங்க எல்லாமே சீ கடல்ல இருந்து மீன் பிடிச்சு சாப்பிட்டு கத்துக்கிட்டு அழகா அந்த பறக்கிற கலையும் நல்லாவே கத்துக்கிட்டாங்க ஆனா இந்த சீகள் மட்டும் மனசுக்குள்ள ஒரு பயத்தோட தடுமாற்றத்தோட தயக்கத்தோட இருந்ததுனால பறக்க தெரியாம அதே இடத்துல இருந்து ரொம்ப கஷ்டப்பட்டாங்க அவங்களுக்கு உணவு கிடைக்கல இவங்க எல்லாருமே சேர்ந்து இவங்களை வந்து என்கரேஜ் பண்ணாங்க வா முன்னுக்கு வா ரக்கி விரிச்சு பறந்து பாரு உன்னால பறக்க முடியும் இல்லைன்னா சாப்பாடே கிடைக்காது நல்லபடியாகவும் சொல்லி பார்த்தாங்க அந்த பறவை கேட்கல இவங்க வந்து திட்டவும் ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க தே ஸ்டார்ட்டட் ஸ்கோல்டிங் ஹிம் ஃப்ரைட்டன்ட் ஹிம் இல்லைன்னா அவனுக்கு சாப்பாடு கிடைக்காது நீ அங்கேருந்தே இறந்து போயிடுவ அப்படிலாம் கூட சொல்லி பார்த்தாங்க shouted at him ana and parva vandu kekra because thanake thannambike illa andu vandu oru thannambike illa na nama vaalva eppadi nama soorndu poiduvomo andu madri inda parvaiy soorndirundathu pasi porukka mudiyada pasi mayakame vara mari pasi illa enna pannudhu pakkathula andha nest irukku koodu kattna nest irundhilla adu pakkathula irundha kaainda mackerel oda tail mackerel nu vandu oru eye mean mackerel nana tail oda eduthu saaptirukku mutta oda eduthu saaptachu அடுத்த நாள் அவங்க அம்மா என்ன செஞ்சாங்க ஒரு மீனை பிடிச்சி அதோட சதையை கிழிச்சு கிட்ட காமிச்சு இங்கே பாரு உன்னோட ஃபுட் இருக்குன்னு காமிச்சாங்க அப்போது அந்த பேர்டை என்ன பண்ணுச்சு கிட்ட வந்து பிடிக்கிற மாதிரி வரும்போது தாய் பறவை என்ன செஞ்சு விலகிருச்சு விலகிடவுன்னு அந்த பறவை தானாக கீழே டைவ் பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சு கீழே இறங்க ஆரம்பிச்சு சூப் ஆக ஆரம்பிச்சு ஆரம்பித்து தானாக பறக்கக்கூடிய கலையை கற்றுக்கிடுச்சு இதுதான் இந்த ஸ்டோரி இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் ஆகும் நம்ம அடுத்த வகுப்பில் பார்க்கலாம் இப்போ கொடுத்துருக்க உங்களுக்கு ஹோம் ஒர்க்கும் எக்ஸசைஸும் வீட்டில் பார்த்துட்டு நாளைக்கு வாங்க நாளைக்கு சந்திப்போம் தேங்க்யூ சில்ட்ரன் யூ ஆர்